Today, you guys, we are talking taking two-dimensional shapes and making them look three-dimensional. So we're going to be practicing drawing some of our beakers, and we're also going to practice drawing some of our bubbles. So let's get started. So here I have just a plain sheet of paper. I'm going to start right away with a Sharpie. You can start with a pencil if you want to. We're going to be drawing three different beakers on here. And beakers are those things that scientists use for experiments. They use them to hold liquids, and they usually have measuring marks on the side. So I'm going to start with one. I'm actually going to start with one kind of in the center here. So then I have room on the edges. So I'm going to start with an oval, and this is going to be the opening of the beaker. Then I'm going to go ahead, and I want that oval to be maybe, you know, 3 or 4 fingers wide, maybe as wide as my hand. Then I'm going to go ahead and take a line straight down, and a line straight down. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to give this a smile, just like this. But I'm not done. Since the beaker is made out of glass, I'm gonna see through, and I'm gonna see through to the other side. It's already three-dimensional, but it's glass and see-through. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add another curve going like this. And it starts to make it look like I can see that back edge of the beaker there. Now I'm gonna add in where the water or liquid is going to go up to. So I get to decide how full do I want my beaker. I'm gonna have it go maybe to about here. So this is where I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna draw another oval, just like this. This is the level of my water. I'm gonna put in some marks on the side so that it really looks like a beaker to me. So I'm gonna turn my page like this and I'm gonna okay, so there's my mark. So there's beaker number one. Beaker number two, I want to make it be a little bit skinnier on the top and then wider on the bottom. So I'm going to start with a skinnier circle or oval. I'm going to draw some straight lines down. Looks like a straw. From here, I'm going to come out on an angle. I'm going to give it that smile. But I'm going to continue back there. And then I'm going to put my water level right there. And then I can go ahead and put some more marks. All right, and now the last one I'm going to do is going to be similar to this one, but maybe a little bit more rounded. So I'm going to start with that oval at the top. I'm going to come straight down. And from here, I'm going to start to go out kind of rounded. So I'm going to come around. I'm gonna do that smile, and then another smile, or frown, I guess. And then the water level, I'm gonna have this one be less full, something like that, and put my marks on. I think this one I might not put numbers on, I might just leave it. I can add them in later. All right, now we get to fill it with a potion. So this is where we're gonna get our watercolor paints. We need our watercolor paints, our brush, and a little cup of wine. So this technique we're gonna try today is called wet on wet. So I'm actually gonna make part of my paper wet first with just plain water. And then I'm gonna use some of the watercolor paints to get it to look like a potion. So I am going to start by getting this area here, so the top level of the water or liquid, all the way down to the bottom. I'm just going to add some water to that. So here we go, my little bit of water, and I'm just going to add water. No paint yet, just water. All right. Now I get to choose a color. I'm gonna choose red, and I'm just tickling the surface of that red. When I do that, since I have water down there already, it kinda gets blobby. And I'm gonna go ahead now and I'm gonna choose maybe one other color to add in there. Things I wanna do, I wanna stay away from the opposites. So if you remember, the opposite of red is actually green. So I don't wanna add green to this, or I'm gonna have kind of a brownish color, which is fine, but I don't know that I want my potion to be brown. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna find blue, because maybe where they mix, it might make purple. So let's see here. If I mix my colors, my primary colors. Ooh, look at that pretty potion. Wonder what that one does. There we go. All right, moving on to the next one. I'm not gonna do any more with that. I'm gonna just add the water first. And then the colors. Alright, this part should not take you very long to do. You're just gonna go ahead, finish up maybe only two colors, remember, in each potion. You're gonna put this off to the side. One thing I forgot, your name. Don't forget your name. If you're in the art room, you're gonna put this on the drying rack. You're gonna be really careful though carrying this over. Don't tip it because your potions will spill. Take it over to the drying rack as flat as possible. If you're in the classroom or at home, you're just leaving it flat like this. Maybe you can move it off just to the side of your desk. Be really careful with your water dishes. You're going to want to make sure you take those over to the sink and gently dump them out. Your brush, just do what I did. Give it a few wiggles, wipe it off on the side. You're going to put it back in the tray, and then with a little paper towel, I'm just going to take that paper towel and place it on top and close it up just a little bit. It's not gonna close completely, but what this does is it allows air to get through still so that the paints aren't so sticky for the next time that we use it. Put those off to the side and get yourself cleaned up. Thanks. All right, the next step for our science picture, I guess, is going to be drawing these bubbles in the background. Hopefully you had a chance to watch that bubble video. If not, maybe you can watch it while you're drawing some bubbles. And you could notice that the bubbles all have reflections in them. They're all typically round-ish, right? Some of them morph into slightly different shapes. But there's also colors that get reflected off of them. So we're going to be using a variety of colors. The shape that we're mostly using today is a circle or circular lines, and we're going to make our bubbles look three-dimensional by adding some of these things in. So what we're going to do is start with a plain black piece of paper. I have this 12 by 18 here, and we're going to be tracing things that are round, and you're going to use from your pack of crayons that I have at your class or in the art room the white crayon to start. Now if there's not enough of them for you, you might need to just be patient, or maybe your teacher has some extra white crayons for you to use. And I just went around the art room and I found some objects that are circles. So here I have this yogurt cup, and I'm gonna trace this a few times just on my page. Ahead, and I'm going to make some reflections. I want to put at least two reflections, two shiny spots on each of those bubbles, and they're going to go kind of around the edges of them, towards the edges anyway, and they are rounded lines, not full circles, but a little rounded. So I'm going to make mine a little thicker. So there's one, and there's one. Here's one. All right, so now I'm done with getting the shiny spots in. I can use the other colors now. I'll put my white crayon away. I can use those other colors to start getting more reflections in. So I'm just going to take and I'm just going to add a little bit of color, a little bit of reflection for some of those other colors that maybe might show up. I can have just one color on each bubble, or I can mix it up and I can have multiple colors on there. I want to make sure not to fill it up too much. I want some of the black showing through because, remember, they are kind of see-through. So we can see through to the other things around it. For the last part of our project, we're going to need our painting from the other day. Hopefully it should be dry by now. We'll need our bubbles, we'll need some scissors, and we'll need some glue. Glue sticks work just fine. So what I want to do is I want to get these beakers cut out and put onto the bubbles. So I'm going to start by cutting, and when I'm cutting right next to the line. I'm not actually even cutting on the line. So I'll take my scissors and I'm going to carefully cut right next to that line and get all three, or as many as I have, beakers cut out and ready to glue down. Alright, before I do anything else, I'm going to take my scraps and I'm going to put them in the recycling bin. Okay, I'm done with my scissors, so I'm going to put those aside. And I'm going to assemble my beakers here. And I'm just going to kind of, before I put any glue on them, I'm going to decide where I want them to go. I notice I have got more bubbles here and some empty spaces here, so maybe I could put these inside some of those empty spaces so that I'm not covering up my bubbles as much. They can be tipped from side to side. They can be one higher than the other. You can decide where they go. But once you decide where they go, take them, flip them over. Make sure if you're using a glue bottle that it's open. Turn it upside down. And we're gonna just put some dots on here. So I'm gonna just do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Lucky number 7. Turn it over. And I'm gonna hold this. Now, since it's been painted, the paper's kind of wobbly, bumpy. So I'm just gonna hold this down a little bit. And if I see glue oozing out a little bit on that side, I don't think you can see that, I'm just gonna go ahead and take my finger and wipe it off and then rub my fingers together. I still have to hold this down because I notice it's still kind of peeling up off of the page. You're the boss, remember. All right. I think I counted to probably 20 there, so now I can hopefully let go and it'll be just fine. All right, then I'm gonna move on to some of my others. Same thing, dots of glue, hold it down until it sticks. I have some extra time, I could take my crayons and I could maybe draw some more bubbles in. I could take and I could add some more little lines in there. Maybe there's like smoke or something coming out. Maybe there's some patterns in between. You decide what you're gonna do, but you're gonna also make sure you take a crayon and put your name on the back. And your class code. This will go on the drying rack if you're in the art room, or it will go somewhere off to the side if you're in the other room. Make sure to bring it to art next time you come to the art room so that I can see it. Nice job.